Let's talk about the prison industrial complex for one second. Marcus Conti reporting on the prison industrial complex, the idea that if you show up drunk, you'll get, if you show up to your sentencing drunk, you'll get drug rehabilitation as a bonus, and you'll get out of jail about a year earlier. Right? Is it a scam? Is it a ripoff? Check this shit out, right? So here's the photograph, right? You remember Cesar Sayoc? You remember when I was down there and next to the court? You see the building in the background right over here? That's the prison. That's where Cesar Sayoc allegedly is. And this is the federal court, 500 Pearl Street, right? Just a little side note, but that's where this is. All this shit goes down. This is the shithole of the federal prosecutorial system, is the Southern District of New York. All the shit happens here. All the scams and the ripoffs go down in New York. So show up drunk, indictments spotlight prison rehab scams. So prison rehab is a scam? What? So this is all tied to the stock market, right? The prison industrial complex, right, it's not about rehabilitating people. Why do we have almost 3 million people in America in prison, right? We have 3 million people in jail and subject to, you know, abusive behavior, but also slavery, right? We have this system where 3 million people are working at slave wages inside jail once incarcerated. See, they're not protected by the Constitution. It's a loophole, right? So they got these. But there's other ways to prey on them, not just get them to work for a dollar a day and a little bit of a better, you know, make their life miserable. That's the prison mentality. You go into prison and your life is miserable. Now, if you want it to be a little better, you could work all day. And then instead of getting a pile of mush, you get, maybe you get some French toast or a pancake, right? You start to work for food. You want heat in your cell? Well, you got to work. You want fucking, right? So it's not, they use the living conditions as well to suck work out of the workers, but that's not the story. So show up to your arraignment, to your sentencing drunk. It's a tip that has been passed on to convicts for years. On your way to federal prison, say you have a substance abuse problem and you could qualify for a treatment program that knocks up to a year off of your sentence. Wow, sounds like a good deal. Federal prosecutors have long suspected abuses in the program, which has enrolled a deep list of high-profile convicts. Recently, a grand jury in Connecticut indicted three people accused of coaching ineligible convicts on how to get into the residential drug abuse program by telling them to show up to prison intoxicated and fake withdrawal symptoms. The charges are among the first filed against prison consultants involving the program. The cases put a spotlight on the unregulated world of prison consulting, in which some ex-convicts and former prison employees charge thousands of dollars for their inside knowledge to help people prepare for life behind bars. Some consultants say there has been wrongdoing in the industry for decades, including encouraging clients to scam their way into rehabilitation programs. So what do we have here? We have basically a broken criminal justice system where you see people gaming the system, right? Now, does this guy right here, right, this lobbyist who makes his living on that rehabilitation, or the doctors or psychologists, do you think that they have any interest in helping the people, or do they have an interest in keeping things exactly as they are? This is the tragedy of privatizing jails. This is the tragedy right here, right? This is one aspect, the slave labor, but also the medical industrial complex, that there's money to be made in keeping the system the way it is. You, the taxpayer, you pay out of your pocket to keep 3 million people in jail, and these scumbags come in there and make money on the back of the incarcerated, right? It's a big scam. That's why, like, oh, but it's socialism. No, we can't have socialism. So, well, why? You want to have a You want to have a medical doctor in the facility? No. That's socialism, right? You want, no, 3 million people, they're all guilty. You see what happens? This bullshit idea of everything should be private. It's killing the fucking economy because it doesn't suit the needs of the civilization. It suits the needs of a couple of greedy oligarchs. And that's what this story demonstrates very, very clearly, that this is an example of the prison industrial complex run amok. Get rid of it. Get rid of, take away private entities in the prison. Why don't you just make the prison fucking private? Make the whole thing private, right? Hire your own guards, hire your own fucking everybody, right? And there's unregulated too, so you could torture people, you could beat people, you could hang them upside down if they don't want to work hard enough. Or you can work towards prison reform. You could, half of the people in there are in there for drug crimes. They're not even violent criminals, right? Work on the social issues, the issue of decriminalizing drugs, for one. That would be a great idea. Decriminalize, right? Get all the dirty money out of the hands of these creeps that are making money on the back of a military, a prison industrial complex. Marcus Conti reporting.